Hi, my name is Jordan. I'm 34 years old and I'm a freelance personal trainer. My specialty in personal training is strength conditioning in martial arts, calisthenics, and also bodybuilding. To train well, I train anybody, to be honest. Of course, athletes would be fantastic, but currently my main customers are people who work in corporate jobs. I mean, they have their corporate jobs, they're in a corporate field, and there's some students, there's also, yeah, mainly people who work in the corporate field. Yeah, so everyday white collar worker, 9-to-5 jobs, yeah, those kind of guys. I like to cook. I was previously a chef before becoming a trainer again. So I took a break from personal training and pursued a culinary art course. And I was in the field, in the chef field, working for 5.5 years before I decided to leave the F&B field and pursue personal training and fitness as my career. So yeah, I enjoy bodybuilding right now because I'm actually in my off season and I'm still preparing for possibly an IFBB competition in somewhere in Southeast Asia. It should be Vietnam, hopefully next year. Oh, my proudest achievement was actually last year when I stepped on the stage first time in KL in a bodybuilding competition under the under NABBA WFF, short form for NABBA WFF. Yeah, they are a bodybuilding association, and yeah, they organized a competition last year in December, and it was my first time stepping on stage, and I was so proud of myself because I've always wanted, since when I was like 18, 19 years old, I really wanted to step on stage and be like those competitive bodybuilders I've always idolized. And I kind of hesitated like throughout the years because I wasn't really secure and I felt that I did not have the proper guidance and in nutrition guidance and also in workout guidance as well. And then when I met my coach, Man Long, yeah, I felt really good and he guided me through and I went for my very first competition last year. Until now, I'm still living those thoughts in my head. I'm married, happily married. Yeah. Well, I've always been passionate about food, you see, but it was not until I've met one of my really close friends who really influenced me into really getting deep into cooking and into the ingredients, right? Into food in general, that I started pursuing that journey, that interest in food. So that's the reason why I left the fitness field for a little bit, well, for 7 years exactly, and I went and I took up a course in culinary arts under the IMI University of Lucerne, under KDU, and I studied for 2 years including training, and then I was out in the field for 5.5 years as a chef. I was a pasta chef. And my last post as a chef was a pizza chef, and I was trained to do Neapolitan style pizza. I've started my personal fitness journey since I was 15 because mainly the reason why I went to a gym was because my mom said I was just too fat. I was overweight, I was obese. Yeah, I just lived a very sedentary lifestyle and I was just lazy, really. But my mom was worried for my health and she couldn't take it anymore, so she gave me some money and to join the gym, a local gym near our office, and that was in SS2 in Petaling Jaya, and that was the very first time I stepped in the gym and started working out. As of being thick and muscular, I guess maybe throughout the years, because I started off with kickboxing and then I pursued boxing right after that, so I have a martial art background as well. And then I stopped that and I started doing, you know, picking up powerlifting because I realized I actually like lifting weights, right? I like building a big body and I've always idolized big guys, as I said earlier. I've idolized big guys, those guys that always go on stage showing off their physique and in those bodybuilding competitions. So I figured that's something I really want to do, and yeah, and it still is. Absolutely helped with my self-image, because like, as I said, I was really fat, and back then, I guess this is quite stereotypical, not stereotypical, but I guess this is quite typical of most guys. Whenever they start going to the gym, they just want to impress chicks, you want to impress girls, you want to have like nice abs, slim body, so that girls will fall for you. But the sooner, like, you know, once you've entered the gym and start working out, build a nice physique, you realize that's not the case, that's not true. In fact, there will be more guys admiring your physique. But then again, as you continue working out, you do realize that you're actually doing this more for yourself and for your self-image as well. And you do feel good and you feel strong and confident. I mean, I guess it would actually build a lot of confidence in yourself when you start lifting. Once you start looking good, your back start to get like, you know, you have a more firmer stand, a frame as well, and you look aesthetically pleasing as well. So yeah, I guess it really helped with my self-confidence in me. Well, my wife, okay, so here's the thing. When I met my wife, I was not this thick. I was actually pretty slim, so I went through a few phases that I was going from really thick muscular to slim to thick to slim to athletic to thick again. So when I first met my wife 8 years ago in 2014, when we started dating, I was actually pretty slim. I didn't have this facial hair, I didn't have long hair. I think would probably be personality. I like to think it's personality more than muscles, because I think she slowly grew into the muscle thing, but it's, yeah, I don't think it was because of that she fell for me. Well, if you're looking to get fit, you want to build strength, confidence, you want to build strength and confidence in yourself. I'm also a boxing coach, by the way, so if you like to learn the fundamentals and mechanics of boxing. Other than that, if you want to change your physique, you want to change your lifestyle, do hit me up as well. That's what I specialize in. Nothing in particular, except that you are determined with you're determined and you're clear with your goals. And the thing is, the rest you just leave it to me, because I will guide you in clarifying or, you know, filtering that goal and to something that they want.